Greetings, beloved light warriors. It's Saratoga, and this is your weekly focus card reading for the week beginning June 14th through June the 20th, 2021. If you're new to my channel, welcome. And you should know that I do this every Sunday so that we can reset our focus and our energy for the coming week ahead. And then I do my regular on-camera videos on Tuesdays and Fridays. Okay, let us get into this week's reading. This is a wonderful card. There's a number of messages coming from this card. So the card says, wandering path, enjoy the journey. So I think I want to start by focusing on the words at the top, wandering path and the fox. A fox is basically a very kind of focused and responsive and agile and cunning animal. It's got a certain kind of intelligence that I kind of think of a fox as being something that is not distracted from its goal, from its aim. So let's put that together with the wandering path. And you can see in this image that the fox looks very focused on that X on the map, like that's its destination, that's where it intends to go. And then there's a compass on the map, which says that the compass, it says the fox knows its direction and knows its intention. And even though the path might be kind of meandering, it's going to reach its goal. So let's look at it this way. The wandering path, I think, is related to the fact that the world we live in right now is so unpredictable. I mean, oh my gosh, there's so much going on. There's so many things. I mean, look at the last year and a half, guys. I mean, we've had the craziest year and a half one could ever imagine. And it could potentially be getting even crazier. One never knows with the way things are happening on this planet. But that's really because ascension is a very unpredictable process and it can include a lot of upheaval. So whenever you have upheaval, you have, if you look at the image in the back of the card with the meandering path going over hills and into valleys, it's kind of like symbolizes that environment of upheaval where it's not a flat, straight line. So that's the environment within which we try to set our intention to manifest. And it's really important that we set that intention because when we do, we strengthen our ability as creators. When we set an intention for our life, for how we want our life to unfold, that is so important in an ascension process because you're strengthening your abilities as a creator. You are opening yourself up to your actual true level of power. So a fox is I think the image of the fox represents, we need to be very focused so that we can be very responsive to that meandering path. I also want to mention that on June the 20th, which I think is Sunday, next Sunday, we have the solstice, the summer solstice in the northern hemisphere and the winter solstice in the southern hemisphere. Sorry guys, it's the braces. It makes it hard to talk a lot of the time. Anyway, okay. So the solstice is an interesting moment because it creates almost like an illusion that for a moment the sun stands still. So for example, in the northern hemisphere, we have the longest day and then right after that moment of that solstice, it starts to shift where the days get shorter. And the opposite happens in the southern hemisphere. So it's almost like that moment of a sense of the sun standing still, even though it doesn't really, but you guys know what I mean. That moment kind of grabs your focus. And so if you think about this coming week, the culmination of this coming week is bringing our energy into tremendous focus. So this is a good week to really contemplate how you want your life to unfold going forward and to take command of what that should look like for you, what that will look like for you. And I'm going to talk in a moment about the words at the bottom of the card because there's something very, very, very important that I want you guys to think about when we get to those bottom words. But at any rate, you can expect that the planet as a whole and the circumstances on the planet as a whole are probably going to look like a wandering path or a path of upheaval or a path of unexpected change, unexpected changes in direction. All kinds of stuff could be going on. So as we move forward in our individual lives toward our individual goals, we want to maintain that compass, like you see in the image, that compass of being really clear about our vision and about our intention and where we are going. We want to be as responsive and agile and intelligent and focused and adaptable and alert and all of those qualities that we associate with the fox. Okay, so the starting point is always to know what your intention is. What do you intend to manifest? What do you want your life to look like? Remembering, as I said a few moments ago, that it's so important to exercise your ability to create. We have such a tendency on this planet to wait. And especially when there's so much unpredictable change, it's easy to fall into a pattern of waiting to see what happens next before you decide what you're going to do next. I want to suggest that you not fall into that trap. Instead of falling into that trap of waiting, because if you wait, you're going to end up reacting to what happens next instead of responding. We want to be in a position of responding. We want to be responsive, just like the fox, okay? So the only way you can be responsive, the only way you can even know how to respond, is you have to know what your destination is. You have to know what your personal goal is. And that's how you know the best way to respond to the changing circumstances on this planet. As I said a moment ago, if you don't do that, if you just wait to see what happens, you're stuck reacting, and you don't know if your reaction is going to be in your best interest or not because you're caught by surprise. So putting that all together, I think this is a strong reminder to spend this week thinking about that solstice at the end. Where do you want your focus to be? Where do you want your aim in life to be? What do you want that aim to be? What destination, what manifestation do you want to create for yourself? Okay, now I want to look at the bottom words on the card, which says, enjoy the journey. And I love this phrase. I want to point something out to you guys that I don't think hardly anybody ever thinks about. And if you do this, it's going to improve the quality of your life so dramatically, it will blow your mind. Okay, so let's say you know what your vision is. Let's say you have created in your mind's eye a vision for how you want your life to be, for what you want to accomplish, for what it is you want to manifest. Let's say you have a clear picture of that end result. Now, most of the time what we do is we stop there. We don't think about our journey. We're so used to life being difficult and being a struggle and things being hard to accomplish. We're so used to that, that we can kind of assume that, well, you know, that's to be expected. Life is hard, but eventually I'll get there if I just stay persistent, et cetera, et cetera. So here's what you want to do. You don't want to stop at just knowing what your goal is. You don't want to stop at just knowing what you want to manifest. You also want to be very clear about the nature of your journey in getting there. So you also want to intend a beautiful, graceful journey. You want to think about the nature of the journey. Because see, life is not just about, oh, I reached this goal, yay for me, right? Life is about moment-to-moment experience. That's what determines the quality of your life. What is your experience moment by moment? So you want to have a stream of experience running through your life that is beautiful, that is graceful, that is as effortless as possible. So I want to suggest that you not just think about the vision of what you want to create or what your end goal is that you want to manifest, but the getting there is what makes it so rewarding. How the journey unfolds is what makes it so incredibly fulfilling. So also think about the journey. Now, journaling about this is a really wonderful thing to do, Because see, like in this image, this fox is looking at a map, right? So when you journal about your vision, you're not just journaling about what you want to manifest. You also want to journal about the journey to get there. How do you want to experience that journey? I've done this, you guys, and it works. It's absolutely incredible. It will just blow your mind. If you put as much intentional energy into your vision of the journey, it will work as well as putting energy of your intention into the end result. So realize that we're supposed to experience a beautiful life. And we can only experience that beautiful life if we remember how important the journey is, that the journey is as important as that moment of fruition, that moment of fulfillment when you actually do find that you have manifested exactly what you wanted. So the other thing I'll add about the journey, about the idea of enjoying the journey, that also includes being fully present. And here's the cool thing. When you are focused on the nature of the journey itself, how you want to experience that journey, it actually encourages in your consciousness to be fully present in that journey. The more present you are in your life, the more fulfilling your life is going to be. So even though we live in this crazy world of, you know, this insane stuff going on, we want to be the light in our own individual world. Each one of us is creating a world for ourselves. So we want to be a light in that world. And we want to create, I'm just thinking that light is actually a transmutational force of energy. So if you think of, I'm jumping around a little bit, but if you think about the fact the world is kind of a dark place, right? It's chaotic, it's crazy, it's unpredictable, it's, in a lot of ways, it's kind of insane right now, right? So it's kind of dark in that sense. So if you are a light in your own life, if you are a presence of light in your own life, you're going to journey through all of that chaos, through all of that as a transmutational force, and you can have a beautiful, fulfilling, a deeply rewarding experience as you go through that journey to reach your manifesting destination. This, you guys, is the best way to evolve your consciousness. It really is. I know that, you know, we talk about things like meditation is important and, you know, various techniques that we can use to evolve our consciousness. But consciousness evolves in movement. It evolves in forward movement. It evolves in how you manifest your life. So what I'm suggesting to you, and what I think this card is really sending us a message about, is if you put all of this together, you are going to dramatically empower your evolution, your ascension, and how you experience your life unfolds, and what you discover you are actually capable of manifesting. One final thing I'll say to complete this: you don't have to feel like you got to manifest this big deal kind of life. You know, I got to have this major thing happen for me. Or in other words, the level of power that you have is great, but you don't have to have a massively huge manifestation to use that level of power that you have. You can create any manifestation you want. It can be very, in other words, it doesn't have to be a big explosion of, wow, that's so incredible. It can actually be just a beautiful, subtle shift in your life, a subtle shift in your reality that improves it and upgrades it and uplifts it experientially. It doesn't even necessarily have to be a massive physical change. But it could be a transformation in the quality of your life and the quality of your experience. So there's a wide range of possibilities that you have to choose from to exercise your power to create and to strengthen your ability to manifest. So you get to pick. That's the great thing as a creator. You get to choose. You don't have to prove anything to anyone. This is just for you. This is just what has meaning for you personally. And I think the great thing about this whole idea that that I'm talking about in terms of what this message is conveying overall, I think the great thing is that in spite of the fact that things on the planet are crazy and weird and insane and all the stuff that we know is going on, that we as cosmic creators, we can actually be in charge of, in command of how we experience this journey and realize more and more and more that we actually live in the universe right now. We live in the cosmos right now. We can exercise our power right now. We do not have to wait later on to see what happens. We don't have to wait to see what the controllers are going to allow us to do. We don't have to do that. It's time to exercise our power now, to be fully present now, and to manifest right now as the light that we truly are. So that's a beautiful message for this coming week. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'm wishing you all a beautiful, fulfilling, inspired week ahead, and I so look forward to seeing you all in the next video. Have a wonderful week, everyone. Namaste.